It's the issue of actually knowing your students.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So I still have office hours, and students who take initiative, who come to me, I actually talk to them. I remember their names, I know them. And I use them as a really good feedback mechanism. So we don't just answer math questions,
mm-hmm.
but then I ask them about the course, do they like it, do they not like it, what the major problems are. And most of the time, especially once they start experience troubles, I get really good answers, not artificial answers. Oh, this is great, I love university, but it's really good objective answers, and that's what I really need. You know, in some sense, you know, you can go into this romantic attitude about teaching, right? That's fine, but also there are other things you should be aware of, right? Students have really poor time management. Time management is not part of a math class, but I have to talk about it, right? And many times students tell me, well, why don't you tell us more of those life things? So not math, but, so I talked to them about, in November, about the need to exercise. I talked to them in November about, you know, the need to eat good food, you know, other than just, I know, cheese dinners or stuff like that, right? So I try to understand where they come from, I try to understand their frustrations, their problems, and then address it. I'm not going to be politically correct in my classes. If they didn't do the test well, I'm going to tell them that. If I think they need to study more, I'll tell them that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, on Wait My Prof, somebody once said, he insults us, but he means good to us.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to insult my students, but if I, yes, I use the word lazy. I don't think it's politically incorrect to tell students, listen, guys, you shouldn't be lazy, you should be working more.
Mm-hmm.
So I think what people will appreciate, even if it is maybe crass or whatever, is this personal thing. So not some kind of artificial relationship. Mm-hmm.